Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back. It's been a while to the Minnesota Twins franchise mode series here in MLB 15, the show on the PS4. When last we left off, the Twins were getting off to a good start here, 25-18 to start the season. Puts them in first place in the AL Central by a game or half a game, I think. They were up, and now they're taking on the Boston Red Sox for three games at Target Field. This is going to be a very special day right here because it is the Major League debut of Miguel Sano. Now, everybody knows in real life he came up and contributed mightily to the Twins this year, crushing tape measure home runs and definitely looking very impressive in his rookie season. So in this version of things, we're calling up Miguel Sano and we are giving him his Major League debut today. Byron Buxton has already debuted in our series here. You see what the Red Sox are bringing for a lineup today. No Dustin Pedroia in the lineup. I think they still have him on the roster in this version of things. First inning, Shane Green is surrendering a base hit to left field there to lead off the game. So Mookie Betts is on, and that will bring up Brock Holt with a runner on. And he works a 2-1 count, and the pitch from Green is going to be deposited to left yet again. Red Sox got something going in the top of the first, getting the first two runners on base and nobody out. That brings up David Ortiz. 2-2 count. And is he going to crush something? Well, that's hop to Mauer, who's going to start a double play. Yeah, Ortiz doesn't run well. They'll get the double play easily. And even worse for the Red Sox, you got a problem here. Brock Holt had a problem sliding there or something, and he could have hurt himself badly. He's got to come out of the game. So now with two outs and the runner at third base, that's strike three to Hanley Ramirez. Goes down swinging, and Shane Green gets out of the trouble he made in the first inning. So there you go. We see Sano is debuting today, DHing, and he's going to hit fourth, hitting in the cleanup spot. Xander Bogaerts has to come into the game because of the Brock Holt injury. So already a not ideal situation for the Red Sox. Bottom of the first, 0-2 count, Brian Dozier. He's going to line a single to left field and get on base. So the Twins, hoping to get something going in their half of the first inning, now have Dozier at first. And Joe Mauer coming to the plate. He's got a 2-2 count here with one out. And Mauer hits this well to the opposite field gap. It's down for a hit and rolling to the fence. Dozier coming around third and will try to score. They will have no play on him, although the throw does go home. There is your first run of the ball game, in RBI double from Joe Mauer. Now here we go. The first at bat ever. Miguel Sano. Oh, that's just foul down the left field line. He's got to come back and try it again. He thought maybe he had his first major league hit right there. 1-2 count, and up. Oh, he couldn't hold up. That's going to be strike three. So Sano will have to wait at least another at bat to get that first major league hit. We'll have to see how this goes. Remember when we called Buxton up? It took him a while because I wasn't hitting with him particularly well. Pablo Sandoval at the plate in the top of the second. He's going to dribble that one through and past Brian Dozier into center field. Nearing a milestone is Pablo Sandoval. That is hit number, let's wait for the graphic here, 999 of his career. One more and it'll be hit number 1,000 for Kung Fu Panda. So he's at first, nobody out, 3-2 count. And this is going to be lined right at Mauer. He grabs the liner and tags out Sandoval. Double play, quick thinking by Joe at first base. And just like that, we've got two quick outs. 3-2 count with two outs. And Shane Green is going to get a bouncer to short. That's Danny Santana coming up throwing. And the inning is over. Twins maintaining that 1-0 lead as we go to the bottom of the second now. And the Twins send Oswaldo Arcia at the plate. The first two batters were retired, and this is going to be a high sky fly ball to right field and taken easily out there. So the Twins go 1-2-3. Joe Kelly settling down a little bit there on the mound after surrendering that first inning run. How about Green? Well, he's going to issue a walk right there as that pitch got away from him to Xander Bogaerts. So he takes his base. And now you got two guys on for Ortiz, and this happened before. This time they strike him out. Man, they doubled him up first time. Now they get him to strike out. They've been playing with fire with David Ortiz there, but so far have not been burned by it. Twins still up 1-0. Let's check in on Byron Buxton here in the third. Hits this one pretty well and deep to right field. Come on, get in that overhang. Nope, it's going to die in front of the warning track right there. So just a long fly ball out. I tell you, he hits well when we see him. He's got like a 320 average coming in here. But when I play with him, yeah, he does not hit well at all. I cannot buy hits with him. There is a fly ball by Dozier that's going to end the inning. And it stays a 1-0 game through three innings. We go to the top of the fourth now. 3-2 count. Pablo Sandoval, and there it is. He had hit number 999, the first at bat. And there's hit number 1,000, a milestone of sorts for Kung Fu Panda. Save him that baseball. He might want that for the mantle. As that's a nice moment there. It's not a 3,000th hit or anything like that. That's going to make him a legend. But, hey, 1,000 hits in the majors, not too shabby. So a 2-2 count. And there's another ground ball to Maurer. Can he start another double play? Looks almost identical to the one they had earlier, as covering the bag is green to make sure they get the double play. So now, again, two outs and a runner at third. This ball's hit well to center field, but that is Byron Buxton tracking it down for the out. And the inning is over yet again. Six hits for the Red Sox, but nothing pushed across. Sano up again now in the fourth. This is going to be grounded to short, backhanded. The throw is going to get him. And Miguel Sano is 0-for-2. Still looking for that first major league hit. Trevor Plouffe up now. 3-2 count with two outs. And he rips this one to left field. Is it off the wall? It's off the top of the wall. And over. Home run, Trevor Plouffe. A solo shot. Just does clear the wall. Definitely a wall scraper, as I think it actually hit the wall. Bounced up and then landed in that flower bed there just over the fence. We'll have to check the replay. But that's what it looked like to me, as actually the in-game call was that it was off the top of the wall. And then it said home run. So they could even confuse the system in the game. Well, let's watch Trevor Plouffe swing it again here as he pulls this to left. Let's see here. It definitely does hit the top of the wall. And then, yep. Settles over the fence there. Nice job. 2-0 Twins after the solo home run. Can Shane Green make it stand up? Well, he's going to walk Alan Craig right there. That's not what he wants to do to start an inning. Most of the leadoff hitters have reached in his five innings of work. I think he's only had one inning where it didn't. And there's ball four again. Man, you don't want to mess around with this. He's walked two guys on now with nobody on. And now the top of the order, Mookie Betts, hits a fly ball. Although it looks like it's staying in the park and will not be a problem. It'll be caught out there. One out for the Twins. Shane Green going to work out of his mess again. Well, we'll have to find out. 3-2 count with one out. And this is Xander Bogaerts. Another fly ball to left field. Looks almost identical to the one right before it. Out number two. Twins just one out away from getting out of the jam. Shane Green working his pitch count up there. He's already to 82 pitches in the fifth. And again, it's David Ortiz. And this time he does get good wood on it, but it is a fly ball out to Torrey Hunter out and right. And the inning is over. Shane Green walks the first two batters, but gets out of it. We go to the top of the sixth inning now. And it looks like Shane Green yet again is out of the inning, ground out, and it's over. Still 2-0 Twins. That pitch count got up to about 100 pitches now, though, so he may not come back for another inning. Here is Joe Maurer going. He had the hit and run on, and the runner gets confused as that hits off the wall. He was waiting to see if he'd be caught. I don't know if somebody faked him out there or whatever. He does scurry back to second base, and wow, we should have had more than that on there. Castillo gets hurt out in the outfield. Second injury today for the Red Sox. That's not looking good for them at all. While they're tending to the injury, you're going to have a relief pitcher coming in for Boston, trying to calm things down here. Victorino's got to come in the game out in right field to replace Castillo. So here's Sano, 0-for-2, looking for that first major league hit. He's got two runners on and one out. He works a 3-2 count, and holy smokes, he hits it deep to center field. And gone! That's the Miguel Sano I know.
What another nickel in the merry-go-round. This one is getting ugly. And how about that? Number 11 got himself his first big league round tripper. We'll have to wait and see how many more of these he can mount in his career, but for now, I'm sure he's happy to say he's got his first.
Well, I think that any kid who's ever dreamed about playing this game dreams exactly this, watching the ball disappear over the fence, then circling the bases in a big league ballpark. I'm sure he was practically floating as he jogged the bases. He'll be replaying that at-bat over and over. You know his phone's going to blow up. He's going to be calling his mom, his buddies. Everybody's going to be talking about this one.
Miguel Sano gets his first major league hit in style. It's also his first major league home run, a three-run shot, and the Twins are in command 5-0. Yes, I know I need to change his number. Actually, this guy right here, Tim Stauffer, is wearing his number 22. I might have to resolve a little bit there. Maybe Sano can drop a little money under the table there to get a jersey swap with Stauffer. Right now, Stauffer is giving up a home run ball to Pablo Sandoval. Three hits in the game, including this home run. He's pretty much the only one showing up with the bat for the Red Sox right now. As it's a 5-1 game, we go to the ninth. Stauffer's worked the seventh, eighth, and ninth, and he gets the ground ball to Maurer. And, man, I just wanted to touch the base, but at least it tagged him to end the game. Shane Green gets the victory. Stauffer works three innings in relief and actually picks up a save because of that. Worked the seventh, eighth, and ninth, and you can qualify for one of those. So, yeah. All right. Sano's got to start talking to Stauffer about that number 22, see what he can do about making a trade right there. But the Twins win the first game of the three-game set 5-1. And, wow, what a party for Miguel Sano, hitting the three-run homer for his first major league hit. But Joe Mauer is your player of the game with three hits, going 3-for-4. So they win the first game of the Red Sox series. We're going to sim forward and see how the rest of the series goes. As a matter of fact, the Twins sweep it. Three games, and now are 28-18, 10 games above 500. Looking good. We'll probably sim forward a little bit further in the next episode. I know there's a four-game set at Fenway Park coming up that I wouldn't want to miss. We'll see you next time for more Twins baseball. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!